In this video, I'll demonstrate how to perform CRUD operations on a PostgreSQL database using a .NET Core application with Entity Framework Core. PostgreSQL is a robust relational database management system commonly used in modern applications. We'll implement CRUD functionality for a user account module, including the importance of password hashing. Let's get started. Let's start by creating a folder for our entity class. Next, we'll create an entity class for the user account. I'll use the table attribute to assign a custom name to the database table. Our entity class will include properties for ID, full name, username, and password. For the ID property, we'll use the attributes like key, database generated identity, and a custom column name. We'll also assign custom column names for all properties. Next, let's install the necessary libraries. The first one is npgsql.entityframeworkcore.postgresql. We also need microsoft.entityframeworkcore.tools to create and apply database migrations. Before continuing, I want to mention that, as usual, this source code will be available on our Patreon page for you to download and reference. Next, let's create the database contacts class, which we'll place inside a folder named data. This class should inherit from dbcontext, a part of Entity Framework Core. Inside the constructor, we'll receive dbcontext options as a parameter and pass it to the base class. Finally, we'll create a dbset for user account. Next, in the program class, let's add the dbcontext to the dependency injection services. We'll use the useNPGSQL method and provide the connection string as a parameter. We'll configure it to read the connection string from the app settings, which we'll set up now. In the app settings, let me provide the connection string. For simplicity, I'll change this as an inline method. Next, we'll create a web API controller to perform CRUD operations. In the class constructor, we'll fetch our dbcontext dependency service and assign it to a private read-only object. First, we'll create an HTTP GET method to fetch all user accounts as a list. This method will return all records from the dbset as a list. We'll also create another HTTP GET method to fetch a user account by its unique ID, which will return the user account filtered by the received ID. Next, we'll create an HTTP POST method to create new user accounts. We'll verify that full name, username, and password are not empty or null. If any are invalid, we'll return a bad request response. If all are valid, we will hash the received password using a handler class named password hash handler, which includes a method for hashing passwords. A hashed password is irreversible, so we also have a method to verify the password during login, returning a true or false value. Saving hashed passwords in the database protects against unauthorized access and ensures security by making it difficult to reverse engineer the original password. I have previously shared a Patreon exclusive sample project for hashing the passwords. I'll use the same code here. After hashing the password, we'll add the user account and save the changes. Finally, we'll return a created at action response, including the get by ID URL and the added user account. I'll show you this response soon for better understanding. Next, we'll create an HTTP put method to update an existing user account. We'll verify the full name, username, and password along with the ID which is needed to update the user account. We'll hash the password, update the record, and save the changes. Once completed, we'll return an OK response. The final method is an HTTP delete method to delete a user account by its unique ID. We'll use the get by ID method to fetch the user account by the received ID. If the user account is null, we'll return a not found response. Otherwise, we'll remove the user account and save the changes. Once done, we'll return an OK response. Now let's add the migration. You can provide a meaningful name here. Once the migration is created, we'll update the database. I have pgadmin installed on my machine. After refreshing, we can see the new database. Here, we have the tables created while applying the migration, and the column names matches the name specified in the entity class. Now let's test our application. First, I'll use the post method to create a user account. Once executed, we can see the user account created in the database with the hashed password saved. Let's create one more user. In the response body, you will see the created user account, and the response header includes the get by ID URL for this account. These details are included by the created at action response. The pgadmin also shows the new user. Next, let's try the get method to fetch all users. The response displays both users. We'll now test the get by ID method. The response shows the user account matching the provided ID. Next, we'll check the put method to update an account. The response shows a successful status code, and after refreshing, we can see the updated details in pgadmin. Finally, let's test the delete method. The execution is successful, and pgadmin confirms that the user account was removed successfully. In the next video, we'll explore how to implement JWT authentication in an ASP.NET Core web API with the user accounts we created. Don't forget to check out our Patreon page. You can find the URL in the video description. Support us by joining Patreon, where members gain access to source codes, early access, and other exclusive content. If you found this video helpful, please like, share, and subscribe to the channel. Thank you.